We thank you, Lord, for your presence. I thank you, Lord, for each one here today, Father God, those that aren't able to be with us. Lord, we just want to worship you. We want to glorify your mighty name. We want to lift you up, Father God, with our praise, with our strength, Father God. Lord, let our voices be anointed by your Holy Spirit today. Let our thoughts be gathered, Father God. Let us be united as one, Father God. Lord, let our voice ascend into the heavens, declaring that you are great and wonderful. Lord, we just love you for doing what you do. You do everything so perfectly. Thank you, Father, for the blessing of this place to gather, for the worship band that you've organized, Father God. Lord, whatever you have planned for us today, we eagerly await to see. We just thank you, we love you, and we ask, Lord, that you would just have your way in our midst. In Jesus' name, amen.
Jesus put this song into my heart. Jesus put this song into my heart. It's a song of joy, no one can take away. Oh, Jesus put this song joy no one can take away. Oh, Jesus put this song into my heart. Jesus put this song into my heart. Jesus put this song into my heart. It's a song of joy no one can take away. Oh, Jesus put this song into my heart. Jesus took this song and gave it melody. Jesus took this song and gave it harmony. Jesus took this song and gave it back to me. Oh, Jesus put this song into my heart. Jesus put this song into joy no one can take away. Oh, Jesus put this song into my heart. Jesus took this song and gave it melody. Jesus took this song and gave it harmony. Song and gave it back to me. Oh, Jesus put this song into my heart.
Sing a la la, a la la la.
this song and gave it back to me. Oh, Jesus, put this song into my heart. La 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 Jesus took this song and gave it melody. Jesus took this song and gave it harmony. Jesus took this song and gave it back to me. Oh, Jesus, put this song into my heart. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for your song, Lord God. Thank you, Jesus. You gave me a song to sing of you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Song of joy. Thank you, Lord. Because of you.
Is Christ in us the hope of glory? Christ in us the hope of glory. He has come to set the captives free. His power in love displayed for all to see. It's Christ in us.
Free is power in love displayed for all to
your holy choir, we proclaim that you are God. We lift you up higher and higher, we shout as one, your holy choir, we proclaim that you are God. We lift you up higher and higher, we shout as one, your holy choir, we proclaim that you are
proclaim that you are God. no other name, no other name, but the name of Jesus. We proclaim that you are God. 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 Yes, you are. Let heaven come.
I hear us all singing this, and this is what I hear. We're all singing this, but we're singing this to the Lord. Lord, let it come. But I hear Him singing back to us. The first word I heard was, tell them heaven's already here. It's in a person. It's in the realm of the Spirit. It's in the Holy Ghost. But I heard Him singing it back to us, saying to us, it's all yours. I did all of this for you. It's to bring you, to awaken you, to cause you to begin to work and live and move in another dimension. Because most of us spend most of our time using our mind. And God is not interested in you fully using your mind until you put on the mind of Christ. He's interested in you moving in and out of the spirit or out of your heart and allowing that heavenly thing to begin to take control in your life. Yours is the kingdom. God don't need power, He is power. He don't need the kingdom, He is the king. See that? He don't need glory, He already is glory. See, all of that is to come to a people, to those who receive Him, those who are willing to allow the Spirit of God to begin to flow through them. That's what it is. That's the whole picture. And that's what I heard Him singing back to us. You let heaven come. One of the things we find, beloved, it's much easier, or we think it's much easier, to allow heaven to happen while we're here in a gathering. But He's really not interested in just in our gatherings. He's interested in absolutely everything we do. Let heaven come into our world. Let heaven come. That's what's going to transform the world around us. The world around us is going to be changed. I think every one of us need to read Isaiah 60 very closely. He said, darkness surrounds you. Think about it. Darkness surrounds you. Adam's in darkness. Everything Adam does, this is in darkness. But you're the children of light. You're called to come. Light will dispel darkness. Whatever is darkness in your world, the light of God will enlighten it. Are you all right? Are you okay? I'm not trying to mess up your feelings, but we got to begin to function on facts. That's the problem with the world around us. It all functions on emotion and feeling, and then it hears voices, and they think those voices are God. They're not. They're voices in their head. God's voice comes out of light, out of truth, out of righteousness, out of holiness. And out of that voice, He begins to speak. And He's not going to come to fix it. He already came and fixed it. Calvary's a finished work. It may not be finished in every one of us because it was meant to do more than just get us redeemed. It was meant to transform us, to change us from glory to glory. You know what I always said? It's like climbing a set of stairs in the reality of God. You get on the first step in glory. But you can't get to that second step till you're established on that first step. Till you got your balance, till you're able to take the next step to go into glory. Then when you step into that next step, how many have ever read the fact that remember Jacob had a dream? And in that dream, he said he saw angels ascending and descending on a ladder or a stairwell to glory. Those angels weren't those created beings. Those angels went from earth to heaven and then back down. If it was those heavenly hosts that He created, it's in the heavenlies, they would come down and then go back up. Are y'all listening? So what He was trying to show Jacob in that very picture, that the transformation from Jacob to Israel, remember his name change? Remember his nature change? That would put him in a dimension that he could go from earth to heaven and function in the heavenlies and bring that back down to earth. And then he could begin to transform earth because of the fact that God had brought him, changed his name, changed his nature, changed his reality. Then he could ascend and descend. Did you learn something today? Say, God isn't interested in me just hanging out here. at this level. What he wants me to do in the spirit, ascend, just like Paul did. He went into a realm. Things that he couldn't explain, things he couldn't understand, but he ascended, but he came back down. And the reason he came back down was because he had a work to do. All right? He had to turn the light on in Rome. Where does God want you to turn the light on? In your world. In your dimension. And when you turn the light on in your world, and in your dimension, hallelujah, he will allow you to ascend again. Come up higher. Come on. Come up higher. Come up higher. Come up until you grab all his glory. Amen. We are changed from to glory. Say the glory is in him, has no end. Because he's Alpha, he's Omega, he's the beginning, he's the end. You get to the end, you're at the beginning. Hallelujah. Love you.
Love you too.
You may be seated. Thank you, guys.